Fifth time playing us. We wanted to make it tough for him. Giannis wanted to limit in transition, and I think we did a pretty good job there.
Pretty surprising, Brad going with Shemmy there. What did that do for you guys?
It made it a little bit easier for us because we could switch. We had to switch in groups. Me and Al could switch. Me and Shemmy can switch. Morrison, Al, JT, we're all the same size, so that made it a lot easier for us.
What did it take to close this team out tonight?
The defensive mindset, limit them, keep them around 100, come out, execute on offense. We still have a lot of room to grow on the opposite side of the ball. Defensively, we did outstanding, but offensively, we can grow a lot. We missed a lot of open ones.
What kind of a boost did Marcus give you?
Tremendous. We welcomed him back with open arms. What he does defensively, see some of those crazy plays, like he's getting up there with Giannis. In the fourth quarter where he comes up with the ball, if it comes down to it, and I have to put my money on anybody, no matter who it is, any sport, I'm putting my money on Sparty's coming out with that ball.
What was the overall kind of emotional impact of him returning? Did it give you a boost going into the game, coming off the two losses? Did you think you needed that in any way?
It for sure helped. His presence was felt. It for sure helped. Just defensively, what Marcus does is it's an added benefit. When he's on the floor, we're a better team.
How do you carry this over to game six, obviously? Do you feel the adjustments with Shemmy and the starting lineup going small will help in terms of the defensive aspect?
Yeah, I think the adjustments at the end of the day is going to come down to who's going to own their space, who wants it the most, and who's going to fight for it. All the X's and O's and stuff, it's just going to come down to that at the end of the day.
Is that kind of the key to this game overall, is having more will and desire even when the shots weren't falling?
Absolutely. I think during game four, they definitely had they imposed their will a lot more. They set the tone. And we wanted to come out of this game and set the tone, so that's what we draw.
Defensively, you want five guys on the street, but that starting lineup had played all of 11 minutes together this season. How were you guys able to make that work?
It's the playoffs, baby. We're amazing things happen, so we just pulled it together, execute the game plan, and came out with the W.
Is there anything about, game, you said played it five times, like game six, Golden in Milwaukee, anything about taking the history, the series to changing your mindset?
I'm not changing my mindset. For what? We came out and did exactly what we needed to do tonight, so we got to have the same type of mindset and just carry it over. We can't, when the crowd gets louder, somebody misses a shot, we can't get discouraged. You gotta have that same confidence whether you make it or you miss it.
Do you still find yourself learning, about this team? It's obviously a pretty much must-win game for you guys. So you find yourself reinforcing things about this team and about the ways you guys can win?
Yeah, learn something new every day with a team like this. We got a lot of potential, and we got a lot of people who haven't even reached their peaks, and just more and more stuff is just coming out each and every day, each and every game, and just. It's kind of cool to see. It's kind of cool to see when we get into these situations and JT shows up, Terry shows up, especially from the young guy, Shemmy starting lineup today. It's pretty cool.
This is the ninth time you guys have played this season, including the regular season. Are things getting a little chippy? You guys sick of looking at each other on the sideline?
It's playoff basketball. If it wasn't getting chippy, something would be off. To be honest, it's supposed to be like that. This atmosphere that we don't feel comfortable in this Celtics basketball. We're going to play hard. We're going to be a hard playing team. So they win, they're going to have to take it.
Any final questions?
We're coming full speed.
The Bledsoe-Rozier thing and Giannis and Bonmaker and all the stuff that they do out there, what does that do for you guys? Does it motivate? Does it anger? I mean, how does it affect you?
It doesn't. We just come out and continue to do what the game plan demands of us. We're trying not to get caught up in all the antics. We just got to play basketball.
You talked about the lessons and learning the level of intensity it takes to win a playoff game on the road. How do you find that again in game six?
I think we found it in game four. We just got to bring it back in game six. Just come out, play hard, and execute on our space.
Jill, this season overall has been very challenging. As a second-year player, how are you able to adjust and adapt to a different situation and step up whenever it's needed?
This is what I asked for, so I can't really complain. It's a blessing to be here in the playoffs, the opportunity, to come in starting in the playoffs, so to winning games and possibly winning a series. So, as a basketball player, this is a situation like you live for. So, I'm happy that where I'm at right now, and I just
Thank you.